This video, I'm gonna share 6 user onboarding mistakes that you need to avoid right now. That's probably annoying new users away from your product. Hey friends, it's Ramli John from AppQs. If you wanna get the latest user onboarding tips and tricks, be sure to smash that subscribe button to get our latest videos. When it comes to user onboarding, anything that distracts, prevents, and overwhelms users from seeing the product's value can be costing you big money. So here are common user onboarding mistakes that you need to avoid right now. First is slapping on a product tour before doing user research. Successful onboarding requires that you have a clear image of your users. And I can already hear you say, well, that's obvious. But you'd be surprised how many people just slap on a product tour before knowing the needs, goals, motivations, and messages that resonate with the users. Some of the things that you might want to know is, does your users have similar desired outcome with your product? Do some of your users need more education than others? Will your users be the final decision maker for a purchase? All of these insights help you prioritize the right kind of message and really establish user flows that best fit a customer's journey. Now, each user might have a different path to purchase. So personalizing the user onboarding experience can really help you increase conversions, tailoring the right product to their specific needs. Mistake number 2 is providing a one-size-fits-all experience. Now, most complex products often have a few different use cases that aligns to different user personas. Offer a generic user onboarding experience for each of these personas. More likely, what you're doing is boring them to death. Or maybe just annoying them away. What you can do is really tailor the experience according to the needs and goals of each user. That will help guide them to see the value of your product quickly. An example of this is Canva, where they ask what the goal is for each Canva new users. And based on that, they suggest relevant templates so that users don't have to go through thousands of templates. As you can see, tailoring that experience really gets users to see the value of your product really quickly rather than doing a generic one. Mistake number 3 is being unclear about the user's aha moment. This ties back to the very first one, where doing user research will help you figure out exactly what your product's aha moment is. It's when new users experience the value of your product for the first time. Hopefully they'll even shout aha at the screen. Now, quicker you can get users to that moment, the more likely they are to stay around and adopt your product. But once again, you gotta be super clear about what that aha moment, or you're gonna leave them hanging in the wind. By the way, if you don't know what your product's aha moment is, put together a video that will help you figure that out in 3 steps. You check it out in the comments below or somewhere on the screen. An example of the aha moment is with Calendly, where that moment occurs when a prospect schedules a meeting for a sales executive that signs up for Calendly. Now, their onboarding really focused on getting that sales executive to send a Calendly link even to themselves so they know what the prospect will see with the link. Mistake number 4 is overwhelming users with too many options. Now, really, that's something that you want to avoid, because users that are overwhelmed are users that run away. If your user onboarding feels like you're stuffing down as many things down the throat as many times as possible, yeah, that's how they start choking with all the information. I understand that you want to get them up to speed as quickly as possible, but doing this, trying to teach everything at once in one sitting, is not the right approach. A much better approach is to do it in bite-sized and digestible portion. A good example of this is with Duolingo, where they focus on teaching users one step at a time, each step gradually increasing in complexity and difficulty. Mistake number 5 is not communicating the value of the product enough. Now, a user needs to hear over and over again how your product can help them achieve their goals. And that needs to be said more often in user onboarding across the experience. And I don't see it often enough. That's where the power of clear and compelling copy and content that shows up on product tours, checklists, and other onboarding elements is very helpful, because they help motivate users by making clear how your product can help them. And they also set the tone and personality of the product. An example I love is with Wave, a financial tool for entrepreneurs. Now, in the sign up page, one of the copies they have really communicates the value of Wave. On it, it reads, send professional invoices designed to get you paid 3 times faster with over $24 billion in invoices sent. I love it because it really gets something what most entrepreneurs want, getting paid. Mistake number 6 is telling it without showing it. This is the problem I often see with product tours and other onboarding elements is bloated copy without showing it. New users often lack the patience to read things and they just wanna see things. That's where really the power of images, GIFs, and videos really cut through a wall of text, because most people will skip a wall of text. But people love images and GIFs. It's skimmable, as well as videos, especially if it's a personal video. Personal videos humanize the experience and imply someone is personally involved in the user's success. An example is a deputy, an employee scheduling tool. They do this well by having a personal video from the CEO who walks new users through the product very quickly and easily. That's all for now. What are other user onboarding mistakes that you've seen? I'd love to know them in the comments below. Also, if you found this valuable, feel free to share it with your colleagues and friends. Share the love. We also created a free user onboarding certification course that details how to create an onboarding experience that turns more of your users into paying customers. We've got the link below in the description. Don't forget to also subscribe to get the latest tips and tricks to improve your product user onboarding. Check out our other video as well on improving your user onboarding. Well, that's all for now. This is Ramli John from AppQs. See you in the next video. Bye.